Welcome to www.sakalavidya.com. Free online classes on mathematics. So already previous we have discussed multiple and submultiple angles in trigonometry. Now we are going to discuss one more important topic, that is transformations. So today let us discuss about the transformations. Transformations. So, what is meant by the transformation? The transformation means change. So, that means one form to other form, the change from one form to other form. So, let us have, what are the such forms? Here, one form is the product, other one is the sum. That means sum can be transformed as product, the product can be transformed as a sum. So now already in compound angles we have discussed some formulae. Once again let us recall those formulae. So we have sine of a plus b. So what is sine of a plus b? Sine of a plus b equals to sine a cos b plus cos a sine b. Let us say this is equation 1. Now, what is sine of a minus b? Sine of a minus b equals to sine a cos b minus cos a sine b. Now, if you add these two, now we get one formula. So let us add these two. Adding equation 1 and equation 2. Let us see what do we get. Now cos A sin B, cos A sin B gets cancelled. We have the sin of A plus B plus sin of A minus B equals to sin a cos b plus sin a cos b, that is 2 sin a cos b. Now it can be formulated as 2 sin a cos b equals to sin of a plus b plus sin of a minus b. That means the product can be changed, the sum of true trigonometric ratios. Now the product has been changed in as a sum of two trigonometric ratios. One is sine of a plus b plus sine of a minus b. This is 2 sine a cos b is there. The sine of sum of the angles plus sine of difference of the angles. So this is one formula. Instead of adding, let us subtract equation 1 from equation 2. So that means equation 1 subtract from equation 2 is subtracted from equation 1. That means we get sine of a plus b minus sine of a minus b. Here what does it become? Minus, these two gets cancelled, this becomes plus, this is 2 cos a sin b. Now it can be formulated as 2 cos a sin b equals to sin of a plus b minus sin of a minus b. This is other formula. Now similarly we know cos of a minus b formula. What is cos of a minus b formula? The cos of a minus b is equal to cos a cos B plus sin A sin B. This also same equation 1. Now cos of A plus B, cos of A plus B is equal to cos A cos B minus sin A sin B. This is equation 2. Now adding 1 and 2, that means equation 1 plus equation 2. What happens? Cos of A minus B plus cos of A plus B equals to, these two gets cancelled, we have 2 cos A cos B. Now it can be formulated as 2 cos A cos B equals to cos of A minus B plus cos of A plus B. So now this is next formula. Similarly, now equation 1 minus equation 2, if you subtract equation 2 from equation 1, let us see what we get. Cos of A minus B minus of cos of A plus B. So this is equal to minus, this becomes plus, these two gets cancelled, we have 2 sin A sin B. Now 2 sin A sin B can be written as the cos of A minus B minus cos of A plus B. So now using this formula, this and this, these four formulae, the product can be changed as the sum of the two trigonometric ratios. So one more thing I would like to share here. The 2 sin A sin B is equals to cos of A minus B minus cos of A plus B. Could you expect what is the value of cos of A plus B minus cos of A minus B? Yes, why not? This cos of A plus B minus cos of A minus B equals to minus 2 sin A sin B. So that means minus 2 sin A sin B equals to cos of A plus B minus cos of A minus B.